Well, we're going to talk a little Christmas. In August now, there's a desire to bring back Toys for Tots, the gift giveaway for families in need. Our representatives with the Salvation Army will now partner with the Marine Corps Reserve to restore the program, but the building they operate out of will need a makeover. Eyewitness News' Katie Fourcade spoke to the new coordinator for the Toys for Tots, and she joins us now live. Katie?
That's right, Shelley. Toys for Tots has not been in operation since 2018, and as a result, the building has fallen into disrepair. We're off to the side of the building here, and take a look. This is supposed to be a wall, but officials have noticed it is just engulfed in plastic with tape just falling off, and they say they're in need of some help to get the building up to code again.
At first, we couldn't understand why no one was picking up the Toys for Tots name and being able to get the resources of getting all these toys, but we realized this huge warehouse on the west side comes with it. But little do we know this huge warehouse has a lot of issues.
It's sat empty for 3 years. Over time, the roof has seen many leaks. It's caving in near the kitchen area now.
Please, we need a lot of help.
Officials say they're asking for donations of supplies.
We need shingles that are going to be completely thrown away with new rubber roofing, and then the side as the building, as you can see, needs completely new siding. So any materials that can be donated will be greatly appreciated.
They say the United Union of Roofers Local 106 chapter will be helping them make repairs. It's a project they say that needs to be done if they want to get Toys for Tots back up and running again.
We can't bring families in here with the smell of mold and with leaks. We have to get those fixed before we do any kind of work in here.
With the end goal of joining these two organizations together to better provide to those in need.
Salvation Army usually serves about 1,200 kids for Christmas. Last time Toys for Tots operated, they served 5,000. So that's our main mission, is just be able to serve more families. And hopefully we'll get 5,000 plus kids helped with Christmas this year.
Officials say there are also volunteer opportunities for the United Way's Day of Caring on September 24th to come out and help them out. Reporting live in Evansville, Katie Fourcade, Eyewitness News.